Hey everyone, it's Jeff, and I've been doing a bit of a deep dive lately on Boston Celtics. And like, one thing that's been really annoying me the last few weeks is every single time I go into like any bit of Celtics related trade rumors on Twitter or Instagram, and like recent trade rumors have been about how Danny Ainge wants to get like a big scoring wing who can basically do everything. So basically Harrison Barnes and just like miscellaneous other stuff. And in all of the comment sections, there are people like talking about how the Celtics should go after a big. There's like, you know, sarcastic comments about how like, does Danny Ainge know they need a center, or stuff like, oh, they already have Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, why do they want another wing? And I feel like, you know, people like that, they really just aren't paying attention whatsoever to the state of the Boston Celtics right now. And normally I wouldn't be that bothered about it, because that's just like, you know, people being, I guess, misinformed. But it's just like the overwhelmingly condescending attitude they have for like Danny Ainge and like the Celtics organization as a whole is just kind of bothering me, because it's lending more like momentum to this whole wave that like Danny Ainge is a bad GM, when he's definitely not a bad GM. And like the myth that he's, you know, like bad or he's overrated, or, you know, like people are just being incredibly fair-weathered about this, and it's pretty unfair. And look, you know, my favorite player in the league might be Jaylen Brown, but like I don't really care about the Celtics. I only like Brown because he went to Cal. So like anyways, when these people discuss how the Celtics need like a center, first of all, they already have like a million centers. Daniel Tice, Robert Williams, Tristan Thompson, and Grant Williams plays a lot of small ball center too. Of course, none of them are close to being, you know, all-star caliber, and none of them match up as well as like in terms of relative to other positions, as well as like Kemba Walker as a point guard or Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum as wings. But like more importantly, and I've said this like a million times, Boston has like no backup wings right now. Like we saw that when Marcus Smart and Kemba Walker were missing time, they were just giving guys who did not deserve minutes way too many minutes. Like no offense to Semi Ojeleye, okay? I think he's an NBA player for sure, but he shouldn't be getting like 25 minutes a game. And you can see just how badly the Celtics were starved of a guy who can just give them quality minutes on the wing, who can, you know, actually be a positive rather than just being like out there running around. Like, I'm not saying Semi Ojeleye was a negative to them, but he just wasn't a very big positive. So like, yeah, Harrison Barnes would be exactly what the Celtics need. Am I saying they should trade for him? Not necessarily. I think if he's only worth a first round pick, then you go for him. But I think to Sacramento, he might be worth more than a first round pick, even if it's like trade value is just quote unquote one first, because, you know, Barnes is still only like 28, 29 years old, and there's a lot of value just keeping him alongside like De'Aaron Fox and Tyrese Haliburton. And like, anyways, about the whole center thing, have you guys seen Robert Williams play recently? The dude has been like amazing for a lot of stretches. And you know, right now he's not quite ready to play 30 minutes a game yet. He makes a lot of just like, you know, classic defensive mistakes where he's just in the wrong position and he just contests late, or he's just not focusing on the right thing, or he just kind of like, you know, botches an assignment. And on offense sometimes, like against the Jazz, pretty late, I think it was the fourth quarter, I forgot exactly when it was, but it was a period of time when the Jazz had a lot of momentum and the Celtics really needed a basket. And basically Robert Williams just like boxed out someone before the shot went up, and sort of play was dead, right? It's an illegal screen in that case. You know, like mistakes like that where you can see them being corrected by just more experience. And of course, more experience and playing time just doesn't, you know, guarantee that he improves. JaVale McGee, for instance, has basically not really improved that. Like he's gotten better, of course, but he never made that like whole basketball IQ leap that he needed to make to be a starting center, despite having all of the physical tools and probably the basketball tool skills too to be a, you know, a starting center. But at the same time, like Robert Williams, he just brings an energy to this team that probably only Marcus Smart brings. And when you're a big man, it's usually a lot more, you know, impactful because you can get rebounds and stuff like that. And when Williams is out there just like not making a ton of mistakes, he's a phenomenal center for the Celtics, because he's basically filling exactly what they need from a big man position. Like, you're talking about Andre Drummond, Robert Williams can like sometimes do that, what, you know, what Drummond does, but for 30 times cheaper. And he's shown just like so much growth already this season, in I think his, what, third year? I just think it would be crazy for Boston to just kind of, you know, sideline him just to bring in someone like Andre Drummond. And it makes more sense if you're trading Williams for like Nikola Vucevic, right? And you're getting back a star like center, like Karl-Anthony Towns if he gets unhappy. But it just doesn't make sense to just to get to someone who's only marginally better, who's only like a top 15 center, because Timur could easily just be that guy by like the next 2 years. And like, of course, there's a learning curve, right? But that's why you have guys like Tristan Thompson and Daniel Tice there. you know, to play when Robert Williams is out there just making a ton of mistakes. Because like the upside there with Williams in the game is just so high. Like during this game against the Jazz, like low key, I think Boston kind of got screwed with the whole foul calls. Like I think they only took 4 free throws the entire game, and all 4 free throws are off and one plays, which is kind of crazy. Like they literally did not take any other free throws besides that. And they also got some pretty questionable defensive fouls called on them at the end. Like, I guess there are fouls, but I feel like I've seen those like in the NBA a bunch of times already before, so I don't know if I would count them like legit calls. But like there was a period of time in like, I think the 3rd quarter, Celtics were catching up. It was like Robert Williams, Marcus Smart, Kemba Walker, Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, and they were just killing it out there. Williams is basically kind of like Clint Capella, essentially. Like, imagine if you added Clint Capella to the Celtics right now, how good they would be. That's what kind of what Robert Williams could be for Boston. And like, yeah, of course, there's no guarantee he actually turns into that, of course, but he's looking promising. And it's not like the Celtics have a closing championship window or anything, because Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum are also in like their, what, 4th and 5th seasons, respectively? And like, I get Kemba Walker is getting older, right? But he's already settling into a third option role. And so I just don't get what the sense of urgency surrounding Boston, in particular with this year, is. Like, they don't have to make a move to get anybody. Like, it would be nice to get somebody, but it's not a necessity because this isn't their, you know, do or die year. It's not like they're the Clippers or the Bucks. And I'm not saying like it's the do or die for those teams either, but those teams have a lot more pressure to win this year. And like even compared to the Sixers, who are still trying to figure out the whole like Simmons and Embiid thing, Boston has time. And like, I know people think that like Danny Ainge is terrible at drafting because he's missed on a couple of like late first rounders. But like, first of all, okay, he nailed the Jason Tatum take. And that was a ballsy choice at the time, because he passed up on Markelle Fultz, consensus number one overall pick, for Tatum. And Tatum wasn't even supposed to go third. Like, Josh Jackson was supposed to go third at the time. And even before that, like, Jaylen Brown was also an incredibly ballsy pick, because he was projected like 8th or 9th or 10th, and Danny Ainge took him 3rd overall without even trading down. And like, I guess you can criticize him for not trading down, but it freaking worked out, right? Because people, like Celtics fans, wanted him to take Chris Dunn or Dragan Bender, and Brown is debatably like, what, the 2nd best player in the class? I think that was, what, like 2016 with Brandon Ingram, Ben Simmons. I'm definitely forgetting someone else, and I'm probably disrespecting someone right now, but like, that was a good pick, right? And even with these like late first rounders, like, first of all, he definitely hit on the Terry Rozier pick back in 2015. And like, yeah, he missed on, what's his face, like RJ Hunter and Gershon Yabusele. I'm blanking on some names right here. Romeo Langford also isn't looking great, although it's pretty unfair to say he's going to be a bust. Although it's also like pretty unrealistic he develops into anything like special with Boston just because they have so many like wings in front of him already. But like, you know, Langford's projections to be like a scoring, like shot creating wing, and already have like Brown and Tatum to do that. And of course, it's too early to tell with Aaron Nesmith. But Ainge also got the Pritchard pick completely right. That was an awesome pick for, at like, what, 26, 24? And the Robert Williams pick is also looking really good now because, you know, it took a bit of time, but he was supposed to be a project. And, like, Grant Williams is also, like, a great pick. I wouldn't say he's a steal, but he's still, like, a solid pick for the value got him at, like, what, the 20th pick? And, like, another thing about Terry Rozier, you know, people say that Boston should have kept Rozier. I think, you know, on paper, and if you simplify things, probably yes. But one more thing, like the reason why Terry wanted to leave was, first of all, he wanted more opportunity because he had that great playoffs run in 2018 and he didn't want to be like the 4th or 5th option. And in Boston today, even without Kemba, he would be like a 3rd option. And so I'm not sure how happy Terry would be with that. You know, it just seems like a mutual breakup was like good. And like, I know it might seem like I just really love Danny Ainge, and like, I do think that back in like 2017, right, when everyone was just like in love with him, yeah, it was probably a little bit unwarranted since he did get kind of lucky. But it's just this kind of like turnaround right now where there's so much hate for him that it's just ridiculous to me, because he's made some good moves. Like, especially now that there's also Brad Stevens hate. Like, can you imagine that? People, like Celtics fans, are hating on Brad Stevens, who's a top 5 coach in the league. And like, yeah, he's not perfect, but literally no coach is perfect. Like, name any good coach in the league right now, and I can point to a bunch of games where they made a bunch of mistakes. Like Nick Nurse, for example, during that Raptors losing streak at the beginning of the season, he was making a ton of bad coaching errors. Greg Popovich, right now, he can be kind of antiquated in terms of like what his offense values in terms of just like, you know, throwing the ball down to LaMarcus Aldridge and stuff like that. But you know, if you're telling me Popovich is a bad coach, Yeah, you're crazy. So of course, Brad Stevens makes mistakes. He makes some weird, you know, substitution errors sometimes, or he like doesn't call a timeout and you're just kind of questioning what he's doing. And like sometimes Brad Stevens like seems surprised that the other team is also allowed to make coaching like changes, but he's still like a really good coach and Boston should hope he's their coach for the next like 20 years. That's it though. This kind of turned into a Celtics rant instead of like more focusing on Robert Williams, but it's just like the people who discuss the Celtics on their internet just really bother me, and it just bothers me more than like any other like team in the NBA because of how little it makes sense to me.